Let's now discuss the distance of bright and dark fringes in Young's double slit experiment. Here you can see this is a typical setup of YDSE in which on a slit plane one are incident light beam incident which illuminate the sources S1 and S2. And on the screen at a distance D from the slit plane, say we consider a point P where the light waves from sources S1 and S2 are arriving. And if point P is located at a distance x from the center of a screen, we know well that path difference between waves from S1 and S2 at P is, this we have studied in the previous section, this path difference is given as dx by capital D. And in this situation, we can say at point P, there is a bright fringe. Bright fringe implies its intensity should be 4I0, that is the point of constructive interference, if this path difference delta is equals to n lambda, that is the condition of constructive interference. So in this situation, when dx by capital D is equals to n lambda, here we can get the value of x as n lambda d by small d. Here you can also put subscript over here, as this can be written as x and b, because this is the distance of nth bright fringe from the center of a screen. Because for n equals to 1, the path difference will be lambda, that is the first maxima close to the center. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, P point will be the nth bright fringe. So this we can write as distance of nth bright fringe from center of a screen, or we can also write it central maxima, as we already studied that at point O, the center of a screen, the maxima obtained is called central maxima. There's a direct relation which will help us in various numerical applications. Let's continue on the next sheet for obtaining the distance of dark fringe distance from central maxima. Here you can see this is the same picture we have seen on the previous sheet, and here we can write if there is a dark fringe at point P, then in this situation here we can write this will happen if a path difference between the two waves at point P will be equals to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. That is an odd multiple of lambda by 2. Here I have taken 2n minus 1 because I cannot use n is equals to 0, because at center it is a maxima, not a minima. And here I can take the value of n equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on for various dark fringes counted from center. So here this is dx by capital D at a distance x from center. This is 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. So the value of x, that is the distance of nth dark fringe from center we are getting, is 2n minus 1 lambda d by 2d. So this is the distance which we can write, the distance of nth dark fringe from central maxima. You must be very careful that for odd multiple, if you use 2n plus 1, then in that case n equals to 0 will be corresponding to the first dark fringe which is closest to central maxima. That's why I have taken this odd multiple as 2n minus 1.